Hello, hello, hello. Welcome, everyone. Sorry for the delay. Sorry, very sorry. But, when you are doing multiple streams in a day, there is always some lag. There's always some delay. And I'm very sorry for coming late. But I can assure you, you're going to have a wonderful next hour or so with one of India's finest talents. It would be also a mistake to call him just a talent now, because he's achieved so much. He's established himself as a fantastic player, triple national champion, I think two-time national champion of India. There are a lot of things about him that we would like to know. In fact, I can tell you a lot of stories about him, because the time when I was playing chess and improving at chess is when Arvind was also beginning to play and improve at chess. So basically, although he's 10 years younger than me, I have seen him very closely improving and becoming a strong player. So a warm welcome to everyone who's here. And I think once a few people join in, I will have Arvind on the screen right now. You cannot see him. It's a blank thing for you. This is our thumbnail for today. And I think it perfectly shows the fact that from a young kid, who Arvind was, you know, fighting so many problems and issues and so many things, he's now become a complete champion. You know, you can see him on the screen here. He's such a, he looks like calm, composed, poised, like a champion. He looks like a champion. So, oh, Soham Kamotra in the chat says, I also have one story. Okay, Soham, please write down your story in the chat. I would be very happy to read it out, because I think you would be also knowing Arvind pretty well. So I guess now that people are joining in, it is the right time to invite the man of the moment, Arvind Chidambaram. Hi, Arvind.
Hi, hi, Sagar. Yeah, so thank you for inviting me. And it's a great pleasure to be part of the show.
Arvind, I can tell you, I'm so happy today to have you here, because I know you do very few interviews. You do not like being on air in public. You know, you don't like publicity. Yeah, yeah. So I'm honored to have you. You know, we have two things we want to do today. One is talk about you, your life. And the second one is to also talk a bit about chess.
Sure.
So, we'll go to chess first, then we'll talk about your life. But first, I want to tell people a story, you know. So the story goes something like this, that when, let me make sure if there's no lag, people in Arvind's voice, is it okay? Is there a lag? Please let me know. So the story goes something like this, that when Amruta was playing in Mangalore in 2010 is also when I was playing, and we both liked each other. We were in a relationship. She was my girlfriend, we were playing that tournament. And at that point, Amruta's roommate was Arvind and his mother. Do you remember Arvind?
Really?
Yes. In 2010 Mangalore, 10 years ago, you and your mom were Amruta's roommates. You were 10 years old at that point, and I was in adjoining room.
I'm really surprised. I don't know.
And I played at that. You remember you played at Mangalore Open?
Yeah, that I remember. Yeah, of course.
And Arvind was this young boy. Let me just show the people how you looked, because it is so interesting. So Arvind was looking something like this. Yeah, he was this young boy with big eyes, you know, like this. And on the chessboard, when he would sit, he would be in his own world. You know, I have also written about this. But you know what he would do is, he would take his hands together and he would do something like flying a plane or something. And then when his opponent would look at him, he would be like, he would bring it back and he would land the plane. and opponent would be like, what is this young kid doing? And he was beating so many higher rated players, you know, he was beating so many strong players. And at that point, I was sure that Arvind would go on to become a very good player. Of course, he's exceeded all the expectations. He's become one of the top players of Indian chess, now in top 10 in India. He's Arvind, what's your ELO now? 2640?
I'm 2641.
2641. So yeah, really right up there with the best in Indian chess.
Yeah, and also like when I was saying, I used to do this, all these funny stuff, yeah, like these days. And bowling actions, some helicopter shots during the game. So
I know that. And you know, you had this ping pong ball, I think some ball, which you used to throw and you used to run and
you mean that smiley ball, yeah?
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah.
You were very naughty, very naughty. Arvind was really very talented. In fact, Arvind, I have one such an amazing picture of you to show people. This one. Do you remember this?
Yeah. I've seen this in Amrita Mokal's post. Yeah, like.
This is 2013. You were, I think, 13 years old at that time.
Yeah.
And your opponent is the very respected GM, very senior GM, Praveen Thipse.
Yeah.
Why do you have this expression?
Maybe it looks like I was shocked or surprised. I don't know. That's how it looks, yeah? And I don't know. Maybe he was explaining something and I'm surprised.
You're like, what? In this position, this is possible. Oh, or something like, how can you analyze so well? Something like this expression.
Yeah, could be, yeah.
But it was such a treat to see you growing.
I also don't know who took this picture. I really want to kill the guy. It is Amrita Mukul.
No, I don't think Amrita. Because at that point in Kolkata, this was in 2012, not 13. 2012,
yeah,
you were 12 years old.
Where Akash won it, yeah.
Yes. This is... she was not there. So this is not by her. Someone else.
Ah, okay.
Soham Kamotra says, I was on fire at National Blitz, 7 out of 9. And I was paired against Arvind Bhaiya and he crushed me so badly.
National Blitz.
Yeah, National Blitz. You played against Soham Kamotra and you beat him. He was 7 out of 9. He was playing very well. He's actually the top rated player from Jammu Kashmir. He's around, I think, 2200 rated. And he's watching this live. And he said that you managed to beat him. So Arvind, can we continue with your life story? It's so exciting. We'll come to chess in a bit.
Yeah, okay, sure.
Look at this picture of yours. Such a nice one. I think you are, what, 10 years old here?
No, definitely it has to be more than 10. Huh?
More than 10.
Maybe some 13 or 14.
13 or 14?
This is the picture when I became a grandmaster. This is the picture taken when I became a grandmaster. So.
Really?
Yeah.
You became a GM at what age?
Yeah, I was 14, yeah.
14. Okay. Remember this?
Yeah, this one was during Chennai Open 2013. Yeah, I think the turning point of my chess career. Yeah, I honestly did not expect that I would win such a, you know, prestigious event. Yeah, I honestly did not expect.
You know, it was actually the World Championship match of Anand Carlson going on.
Yeah. Simultaneously, yeah, it was going on, yeah.
And there was an open tournament that was taking place along with it. And here was this 13-year-old boy who was not even an IM. I don't think you were an IM at that point.
Yeah, I think it was my... I mean, I got my first GM nom here and I finished my third IM nom.
Third IM.
If I'm not wrong.
And you finished ahead of at least 20 GMs in that tournament.
Well, I'm not sure about it. Yeah. What did yours?
You actually finished ahead of 20 GMs, I think, in that tournament. There
ah,
were
okay.
so many
Okay, I
strong.
did not count the GMs. Okay.
I remember there was Vidit playing there. There was so
yeah,
many.
Yeah, actually, I lost to Vidit and now. Yeah, he just crushed me.
But you still won the tournament. You still won the tournament.
Yeah, actually, like I think the full credit goes to Sedu, no?
Ah, really?
Yeah, he was the one who bet Vidit on the last game.
Okay.
So it kind of helped me to become a champion. Yeah.
Yeah, and after you won that tournament, I was also playing there. I think I finished like 30th or something, maybe quite behind. And then at the prize ceremony, when the prize was about to be given, you were actually going to the, I think somewhere we met outside, and I told you, you know, congratulations, Arvind, you won it. You were this young boy. And what you said was, yes, but you know, my opponents didn't play so well, so I won. You know, you didn't even take the credit for your victory. And after this tournament, there was a tournament in Hyderabad, if you remember. And
yeah,
then
yeah,
you
yeah.
traveled with your
badly,
mom.
Yeah.
We traveled with your mom and you were actually distributing sweets there to everyone.
Yeah.
So I know how humble and how nice you
and
are.
And it's true that you can only win a game if your opponent makes mistake. Yeah,
that's true. That
yeah.
is true. That is yeah. true. But many people take the credit for being a good player. you do not. You are like, no, my opponents made mistake. But you know, Arvind, the feeling I got when I saw you when you were very young is that you are such a humble, such a level-headed, such a modest boy. And how did you get all this? Maybe your mother here played a very big role in that, right?
Yeah, definitely. I think whatever I achieve and I will achieve, every credit goes to her. And also I would like to add my grandparents.
That's your grandma, yeah? That's your grandma.
Yeah, grandma. And I mean, of course, they were in the place of my dad. So I think full credit goes to them, yeah.
So tell us a bit about your childhood. How did you learn chess? I think your father passed away when you were very young.
My father passed away when I was 5 or 5.5 years old, and they were the one who took care of me very well.
Your grandparents?
Yeah, my grandparents and my mom. Yeah.
Your mom. Okay. And where did you grow up? In Chennai or in which
city? No. I lived in Madurai.
Madurai?
Yeah.
Okay. And how was it back then? Like, I seen pictures of you very young, like you are running around, you are enjoying, like, how did chess come to you?
My grandfather taught me chess when I was 8 or 8.5 years old, and I started playing chess, and that's how it started.
Your grandfather taught you how to play chess when you were 8 years old, and then
One of my family members told me to play some tournaments, and I went to some district tournament and I found a coach there. And
who was your coach?
Yeah, my first coach was Prasad. So I'm always grateful and thankful to him for what I'm right now, and to all my
Madurai?
Coaches actually. Yeah. Sorry.
So what did you say? You have only had two coaches.
My first coach was Prasad. I learned very good basics from him, and my second coach was Gauss Kamardeen. And when I was with him, I started winning national championships like 11, 13, and I even won this under 19 when I was 12. So
you won under 19 when you were 12 years old.
Yeah, it's surprising, I'm really grateful to all of my coaches. Yeah. And rightly, I'm working with Ramesh sir.
Yes, of course. We'll come to Ramesh sir because we know he's played such a big part in your chess career. But talking about these two coaches, they were from Madurai?
Yeah, both of them are from Madurai. Yeah.
Both of them from Madurai.
Yeah.
And basically, you were like this raw talent. Yeah, no one was sort of you, it's it was like this talent was so raw, I could see it on the board. You could effortlessly make moves, you could effortlessly calculate. You were not even, you know, I remember you used to wake up during the tournaments and watch TV, and then you would go to play the tournament, you would not even practice much. Is it true?
I still don't know. Maybe I was naturally, you know, talented. It all, you know, came with the flow. I don't know.
Did you do some training when you were young, which was unique? Like, what did you do?
I when I was young, I never worked on openings, actually. Till 2600 rating, I mean, I never, you know, worked on opening seriously. Okay, I know a little bit, but I always try to get out of the theory and try to, you know, try to win them on middle games or end games. Yeah.
I have, and when you talk about openings, I have to tell the Arvind variation, if people should know about it. Arvind, shall we show it to them?
And this is a stupid one. Okay, sorry for that word, but it's really stupid. Yeah, this.
How was it?
This rook g1, yeah?
Yeah. B5?
No, he played knight f6. Okay.
He played knight f6. He went rook g1 with the idea of g4. And
okay,
you won that. And by the way, he played it in a very important event. One second. Let me get you on screen here. People cannot see you. I'm very sorry.
Okay.
Yeah, here you are. Ronak Hotchandani sent a super chat saying, level-headed, humble, masterclass on how to live a meaningful life. I agree. In fact, you're going to learn a lot more from Arvind.
Thanks a lot.
Arvind, so this is what you would played once in a very critical game, I remember. You played knight f3.
Actually, it was not critical.
It was last round.
Yeah, I was out of the podium finish, and I won this game, but even if I had won this game, I was never getting a medal.
Okay. But still, this we can always call, whatever you do, maybe you become world champion at some point, we'll name this as Arvind line. So Arvind, tell us a bit about, I remember that financially there were difficulties, yeah, when you were young.
Yeah.
How was it?
So I think I would like to thank my sponsors first of all. I will start with ONGC. They were giving me scholarship when I was even an IM, so that really helped me to become a better player, and I would like to thank Murugappa. They are sponsoring me, and when I was even an IM, and it helped me to become a GM at even an early stage, where I could play some foreign tournaments. So my very good thanks to them. And am I live?
Yeah, you're live.
Yeah, okay. So, and also I would like to thank Microsense, who are sponsoring now. And and to all my sponsors. And in general, I would like to thank all the good people who have helped me in different occasions. Yeah, and I really don't know what to say other than thanks.
I remember that there was a time when you, I think, became an IM, and you wanted to get to your GM title, and there was you were short of funds. And there was a fundraising campaign that was launched by Ramesh sir. I think all of you together on Indiegogo or on this website. Yeah. And in fact, at that point, Arvind, I was just beginning. I was beginning to write for Chessbase. And I remember that there was this small article that I wrote about you, the little talent from India on the rise. And a lot of people read it. In fact, at that point, a lot of funds were raised. And Arvind?
Yeah, I really want to thank all of them for the rest of my life.
Hare, and, nothing like that. But the thing is, actually...
It really helped me to become a GM. And
yes.
If I had not got that chance, I don't know whether I would have become a GM.
You would have easily become a GM. That was for sure, because you had so much talent in you.
Yeah.
But you made use of every opportunity that you got and you became a GM at the end of it. It was really phenomenal how you achieved it. When did you shift from Madurai to Chennai?
I shifted to Chennai when I was in ninth grade, I think. So mainly after working with Ramesh sir. I mean, to work, to work individually with him. So, and also Velamol School was asking me if I could join them, and they are really good at chess. I mean, for chess players, and shifted to Chennai.
So you had two reasons to shift to Chennai. One was Velamal School, who supports chess very well.
Yeah, and also I would like to add my previous school, Dolphin School, in Madurai. They were also helping me a lot. So I should not miss anyone, So.
Well, Arvind, if you miss anyone, we'll have another interview with you and we'll add all of them. So don't worry. I know that so many people, when a journey of such a magnitude has to be carried out, there are so many people who help, and you can't always mention everyone. But I think so. The reason why you shifted to Chennai was Velamal School and R.B. Ramesh. And here's a picture of Ramesh sir. And also there's Susan Polgar here, who is a former women's world champion. She was in Chennai to commentate for the world championship match. And I think this is when you had won the tournament and this picture was taken. Tell us about the role of Ramesh in your life.
I thought after becoming some national champions, I wanted to become, to get even better. And some people were suggesting that Ramesh sir would be helping you to become better. And after working with Ramesh sir, I started winning a lot of international tournaments. I won one world second and the Asians gold, and many tournaments, and and also I became better as a person. He's a nice person, and I love working with him.
He's been there for you since a young age. And I think when you shifted, you tried to find some place in Chennai which was near to the Chess Gurukul Academy, right?
Sorry, I did not hear
you. You wanted to stay near the Chess Gurukul Academy so that you can work regularly, was it one of the criteria when you shifted to Chennai?
It was one of the criteria, and the school, those were the two criteria.
And then you
I'm currently sponsored by both Murugappa and Microsense. I did not say it properly, but I just say no.
You can see how much gratitude he has for his sponsors, because he recognizes.
I never got a chance to say this anywhere, and maybe
you hardly give interviews. That's why. This is another very nice picture. In fact, a lot of people in the chat are saying you look a lot like Pragnananda when you were young. In fact, Pragnananda looks a lot like you when he is young. This is a picture where both of you are together. And who is the boy on the right?
He is one of Ramesh's students. His name is Narendran.
Narendran, Prag, Arvind and Ramesh. And you know, always when I see pictures, you all are very happy and you are always, you know, full of energy. How does that work?
You know, when the class gets over, you have such feeling, you know. Wow, the class got over. So you have such feelings, you know. So I and it was post class photo shoot, I think.
Post class photo shoot. Okay. I want to show the viewers maybe one of the. If we can get it here, one of the dance that you, Ramesh and everyone did, yeah, like what was it? Where was that done?
Yeah, it happened in Olympiad, under 16 Olympiad.
Hmm.
Actually,
yeah, first one. Yeah. Okay, let me share with you with sound so you can also listen to it. Okay. By the way, guys, Ramesh, RB Ramesh has a very nice channel. You can subscribe to it. Would be. Yeah. So who you are on that right side, yeah?
Yeah.
This is you.
Yeah, team event, yeah. 16 Olympia.
And who is this?
He's my friend Sai Vishwesh.
Sai Vishwesh.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Let's see.
And this is Mutaya.
Al Mutaya, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, machi. Did you pass it?
Yeah. Actually,
very
you know,
nice.
They wanted to, you know, motivate at me because I did not score a win where I had to win a game. I just drew that game, actually. If I had won, actually, I was winning. If I had won, we were winning the, you know, match against Hungary. So I was, you know, really worried that I could not do it. So, and these guys and sir wanted to, you know, motivated me and we had this nice dance.
Wow. So to motivate you, Ramesh sir came up with this dance and I think you were very happy after it. By the way, Surya is in the chat. Surya says, Arvind, should I post some dance video of yours? I have got a nice collection.
Is it gangs?
Yes.
Come on, gangs. then Chessbase India, it will get banned. If that is fine, you can post it, Sagar.
Banned by you or by whom? By YouTube.
YouTube, yeah. Okay.
Everyone is already saying Dancebase India to Chessbase India. Yesterday, I played a video of Hari Krishna dancing.
Yeah, it was really great.
You saw that?
Yeah.
So already. Oh, Karthikeyan also in the chat says, don't do it. No, don't post this video.
Yeah, he was also part of it.
Okay. I'll get those videos someday from him. Arvind, then how did you keep improving at chess? This is one picture of yours. I think this is world... Asian champ junior.
Yeah, it's Asian junior. Yeah,
you won it.
Yeah, I won. This one is my first Asian junior champion, and so, yeah, it was a great feeling winning such champions. Srinathana had won it more than thrice, I think. Na Asian juniors.
I think Srinath, Shyam Sundar. And Ashwin Jairam. These are the people who would win a lot of Asian juniors. Yeah,
I
am not mistaken.
And also Srinathana scored three GM norms by winning, three Asian juniors.
Oh, maybe it was Ashwin, I feel.
I think it's Srinath Khanna.
Okay,
I think.
Okay.
So I think I got a GM now here, but I think I was already a GM at this point. So
you're already a GM, yeah.
Yeah.
And you know, Arvind, you had this issue. I don't know if it's an issue, but usually in critical games, you would make a mistake and you would often lose. I remember I was here. This is 2017 National Premier. When in the last round, if you win, you get the title. And you actually lost quite easily to Debashish. The winner was Lalit Babu. And I believe that you had a lot of pressure on you.
I played like Samay.
You played like Samay. I'll tell Samay about this.
Actually, yeah, many people advised me after losing such games, including you. I think you advised me. And they told me to play just normal chess, just nothing special. Just go on and play what you're playing. I mean, the rest of the games. Yeah? I mean, sorry, I did not.
Yeah. No, you are right. So just play normal chess and it would be good. And I think that helped you, that advice. You actually were able.
I think I got disconnected, no?
No, you are here, Arvind.
Oh, sorry. Okay. Fine.
Can you hear me well?
Yeah. Sure.
Okay. So now I was saying that this advice you took seriously because after that, in 2018, you became national champion. This was the runner-up. Lalit became the champion.
And I think after all this, I took it as an experience. And I think now I'm pretty good at handling lost round pressure.
Yeah, look at this. This is your championship title in 2018 when you won it. And you went on to win it in 2019 as well.
Yeah, as you all know, I lost my last game in 2017 and 16, and I could not win the championship. And I took it as an experience, and I did it in 2018. Yeah.
Okay. And then, did you win the Rapid and Blitz title in 2018 also, or that was in 2019?
Yeah, I won Rapid and Blitz in 2019. Yes, 2019.
So I think this feat has never been achieved in Indian chess, that one guy wins the classical title, rapid champion, blitz champion, and he achieved all the three titles. It was simply unbelievable the way you achieved. And you know, Arvind, do you remember this picture?
yeah, it was after Aeroflot tournament, yes. Prize distribution, yeah.
It's I'm also there somewhere. I also joined in
while. Were playing pair blitz, I think.
Yes, we were playing pair blitz. But what I want to say through this picture is the love for chess that you had, and of course even Prag and Vaishali, because tournament was over and you could have easily gone out and enjoyed or done something else, watched movies, but there you were playing chess, enjoying yourself. I think this is what helped you, you know, a lot in your chess career to improve.
Yeah,
you enjoy chess.
Yeah, we enjoy playing chess, and that's what we are doing here.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, that love for chess just is there in your eyes. This is one of my favorite pictures of Arvind taken by Lennart Utes. Looks so smart, so nice. And one more picture here, which I actually showed to Nihal.
I don't zoom in and check out the clock.
You lost it, on time.
Actually, it was 10 seconds plus 1 second game. Where Nihal has 23 seconds.
Nihal has just 23 seconds.
Yeah.
Oh, he has. It is 10 plus 1 and he has 23.
Yeah.
My God. So,
I was playing like a bullet game or, you know, 5 minutes game. And I totally forgot that I was playing 10 seconds and that too against Nihal.
But the main thing to take away from this picture is sitting on the airport and enjoying chess. And, you know, this is again one picture which shows the love. By the way, RB Ramesh is in the chat and he says, "Hi, Arvind. So proud of you."
I actually informed my sir not to come here, but I don't know, he disobeyed my words and
I believe the student should be listening to sir, yeah, not the other way around.
yeah, just kidding. Yeah.
No. So, and here's another very important moment in your chess career, I would say. You played a brilliant match against Michael Adams at the World Cup 2019. It went right down till the wire. You played first two classical games, ended in draws, yeah. Then two rapids, ended in draws. Then two shorter rapids ended in draws, two blitz ended in draws, and finally Armageddon, yeah? Or no, it was still game 8?
No, it was, I think, blitz.
Second blitz game.
Yeah, there were a lot of blitz, I don't know which
blitz. And you won with the black pieces, I think, or something.
Yeah, it was 5 plus 3, I think. Yeah, that's where the game went.
And you were able to beat a legend like Michael Adams, which is
so amazing. Honestly, I did not expect it. And it was my first World Cup. And I did not think that I would qualify for the second round. And also, like, here, I would like to inform you that about Adams. Like, he's a true gentleman. He even, wished me after losing the game for my rest of the games.
Wow.
That is one thing I admire from him. He congratulated me and, wished me for the rest of the game.
Amazing.
That is something, great.
Such a great legend, yeah? Like, I also know you beat another legend, Boris Gelfand, at World Blitz Championship. So you have been beating a lot of such top players now in the world. By the way, Surya, Ramesh, a lot of people in the chat are asking who is your favorite actress?
you can ask me in private chat, no?
Okay, but who is your favorite actress is not such a private question. It's like we ask.
Okay, it's Rashi Khanna.
Rashi?
Khanna. I think she's a South Indian actress, I think. Yeah.
And she has the same date of birth as Magnus Carlsen, yes?
Yeah, coincidentally.
So your favorite chess player is he, Magnus?
Yeah, my all-time favorite is Magnus and
My
favorite is Rashi.
Both born on the same day.
Same day, yeah.
brilliant.
Yeah,
so good,
really
to
funny.
Know. And I think, Arvind, you also like a lot of movies. You watch a lot of movies, yeah?
Yeah, of course, yeah.
You enjoy movies. And also, you make a lot of memes. Is it true?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. No, I mean, I'm just trying to find more things about you.
I thought you're going to publish one of my memes here.
Is there any good one? I saw the Pragnananda one was very nice, where you wrote his name 5 times.
I don't want to take it here.
No, nothing here. Okay.
Yeah, okay.
By the way, I have some nice pictures of little Arvind here playing cricket. Such a cute little boy. In fact, Surya is saying, it's weird to see Arvind sitting so calm and pretending he's very innocent little kid in the interview. But we all know Arvind is very, very funny. In fact, when he was a young kid, look at this. Whose specs are you wearing?
Why am I wearing specs?
Whose is this?
First of all, is it me?
Yes, it's you. I think maybe someone, Swayams Mishra or someone else, maybe someone from that event is what you were wearing. And look at this.
Where did you get all these pics? I don't have such pics.
These are all pictures available only on Chessbase India. No, they are there everywhere. But yeah, simply fantastic. And this is another very nice picture now, making Arvind feel a little bit more comfortable. Winning the national championship in Sikkim, where he won 5 lakh rupees. Arvind, what about your physical fitness? You're doing yoga here. Is it a very important part of your life?
I recently started doing yoga and some physical exercises, and so which is really helping to become a better player. It's really helping me, I would say, because in those days I had no stamina, like even worse than a small kid, I would say, like, I mean, a very small kid or old man.
Yeah.
Now
yeah.
it's.
Now you are much.
I'm pretty good. Okay.
Fantastic. Very good. Very good. Arvind, you know, your journey is still continuing. You know, there's so much more that we are going to witness over the years, what you will achieve. Just, you are 20 years old, 99 born, is that correct?
Yeah, I'm 99 born. 99
born, and when is your birthday?
Yeah, September 11th, 1999.
Oh, so your birthday is just coming in 4 days.
Yeah.
So in 4 days, you will be 21 years old.
Yeah.
And your rating is 2641. You're such a right up there. I mean, I cannot be more excited to see what you're going to achieve in these years to come. What's your personal aim, you know, in chess?
I actually, you know, I want to play good games, actually. It's my personal target. Even if I don't win games, I just want to play good chess. Yeah, that is what I really want to do right now.
You have no real aims like I want to become 2700.
Yeah, I want to become like I want to be, like, as good as Magnus, of course, and I want to reach, yeah, my short time aim, I would say, is 2700.
Okay, short term aim. By the way, you did play Magnus once. I had a picture of that. I don't know why I did not add it here, but you managed to actually hold him to a draw. You lost to him, but you were actually better against him, right?
Yeah, I was slightly better, but I simply
lost
got into his preparation, actually. Like, okay, at that time I was, you know, playing all this B3 stuff and all. So this E4, C5, B3, G6 is really annoying for white players. I honestly, you know, took some half an hour after Bishop B2, Knight F6. I could not, you know, find a perfect place for my pieces. So I took half an hour, which cost me at the end.
I know you were low on time, but I interviewed Magnus after that game, and he said that he was in trouble at some point. He was quite nervous. By the way, you were saying B3 and all this stuff, but I want to say to the viewers, as Ramesh has pointed out, that you played B3 in your game against Shiro, where you had to get your final GM knob as white, and you played B3 and you won that game.
Yeah, in those days, actually, I was really inspired by Rapport.
Richard Rapport.
Like, he's, yeah. Actually, Ramesh sir showed some of his games, actually, and I was really, really inspired by his play. He plays all this, you know, funny stuffs and get a full point. he plays B3 and plays Knight of 3, G3, G5.
Okay.
And so many stuffs, yeah. He plays A3 and H6 instantly.
True. And actually, he inspired you, yeah, to be creative.
Yeah. And regarding this Carlsen's game, I just want to add one thing. But I have said this in many interviews. Yeah, that was the only game I was happy after a loss.
Amazing. Surya says you have also played first move A4. Is it true?
Actually, not A4 here. Knight of 3, Knight of 6, A4. It was...
Knight of 3 is the move which you make to make your opponents feel a little comfortable, and then you play moves
but
like...
I was crushed very badly, you know, after A4.
Who was your opponent?
I think it was Sasian, no?
Oh.
Okay, after this game, I realized that I should not play such openings against strong players. Okay. He simply crushed me.
Crushed you, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, good lesson from a senior Indian player,
Yeah, true.
experienced player. So, Arvind, we want to look at this game of yours. This one is, I think, one of your favorite games. This is against Sriram Jha.
Yeah, particularly one idea I really like a lot.
So we will
Yeah.
go to that position. You tell me to stop, and then we'll
Yeah,
ask the
sure.
viewers to find it. You are white,
Yeah,
and
but
it's
it's kind of a positional idea, and
no
but
problem.
not something fire, nothing fireworks and all.
Well, it will be fun to see. It will be interesting. So
Yeah,
here.
I played a Queen H5. So
How would you assess this position? It's around equal or white is better?
yeah, of course, white is leading development, and white has very good initiative, and after this exchange on c4, black's c7 a5 pawns are kind of okay. He exchanged that d6 bishop. Okay, f4 bishop. So now it's fine. Okay, yeah, let's go on. Yeah, so now my knight is very well placed on c4, and I have the c5 everything.
You have a question from Surya who says, by the way, first Srinath in the chat says, you ended up playing knight f6, rook g8, g5 against Hikaru a few years later. Is it true?
No, it's actually knight f3, knight f6, b3, g5. The point is
One second, one second. Let
to
me get the move. Yeah. Knight f3, knight f6, b3, g5.
yeah, the point is to get the center, like if black takes on g5, e5, and yeah, but it's not a great idea, but the center is our main key, so
Arvind, you are talking about this move so seriously. I get a feeling that this is a good move that you played
no, it's
g5.
just bad. Yeah.
It's bad. Okay. And Surya says, after this, I realized I should not play such things against strong players. That when you played against Shashi, you
Yeah.
said that. What were you planning to play against Surya in the same tournament? Is what he's asking.
No, that's pretty good idea actually. I even saw a book on that opening, Recently there was a book on that opening called and they also named that opening called I will just remember that one. Some Harry opening, what is that?
Ah, you mean the H pawn, something related to that?
Maybe I can show the moves.
Yeah, yeah. What were the moves?
E4, c5. Yeah, in the same tournament, I wanted to play this against Surya. Knight f3.
You are white?
I was black.
Yeah.
Yeah, I played knight c6. And okay, I wanted to go for d4. I mean, c d4, cd4, knight d4, knight f6, knight c3, h5.
H5.
This is pretty good actually with black pieces. Hopefully we can see more games, I think.
Oh, look at Arvind, has so many games. Oh, you have won so many games.
No, but all of them are blitz games and rapid games.
But you have won. You have played this 5 times and you have a 4.5 score against Alexiev, Matsenko, Villalba, Shaolin, and Arjun. My God. Another line
Yeah.
which we can name as Arvind variation, yeah?
I don't
What's the
know.
idea of this move? H5.
Yeah, basically, yeah, white was threatening knight c6 and e5, trying to push back f6 knight, and now we have knight g4.
But this doesn't weaken the square, like I can go bishop g5.
Yeah, bishop g5, I think we can kind of transpose to classical variation, and h5 would be a useful move. No, not d6, maybe queen f5 makes sense.
How do you get this taste for unusual chess, unusual moves like these? Is it something which you had since childhood, or how did this develop?
Yeah, as I said, Rapport is my
Rapport.
inspiration.
Rapport is the person. Okay, got it. Okay, coming back to the game against Sriram Jha, we go to move number 18, knight c4. White has an initiative here, queen c6. If you take on a5 now, then c2 pawn is hanging.','//////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////////// So could be dangerous. So queen f5.
Yeah, so okay, so I doubled my rook here. Okay, b3 first to protect f4 pawn and rook e5. Rook d8 was a little bit not so good. He wanted some rook d5, so I simply stopped with rook e5. And so yeah, here after queen d7, yeah, this is the moment I was talking about.
This moment. Okay, guys in the chat, please try to think what is it that Arvind came up with in this position. Very interesting position. Let me think, Arvind, because I can also learn something from you.
Yeah, sure.
So my thought process would be that we need to do something in this position. The knight on e6 is very solidly placed. Also, it's
Yeah.
defending the d4 pawn. And your knight on c4, although very beautiful, somehow doesn't really help much in doing much. Yeah, so maybe it's time to shift the knight somewhere. But where? I mean, maybe we can get it like here and knight f3 or knight e4 and knight g5, try to exchange, but maybe it's not the best.
Yeah, well, what you said is interesting. But knight d2, I think, fails to queen c6, I think.
Knight d2 fails to queen
I think I
c6.
have to get back to knight c4 once
Yeah,
again.
this is weak. Yeah, okay. Soham Kamotra says, I want to play knight a3 to b5.
But I think knight could be somewhat misplaced, I think,
On b5.
even after knight b5, let's say c6, we have to get back to a3.
Yeah. Okay, so not that. Then what else? Let me see what are the other options.
Actually, it turned out to be engine's top choice. I actually did not expect that it would be engine's top choice.
Okay. Rook e4 is mentioned by Chandan Biswal. Rook d5 by Shavindra Singh. Nihilesh also says Rook d5.
Rook e4 is what you're similar actually what I but it doesn't, I mean, protect the, I think, c2 pawn, I think.
So did
But
you play this
actually
move?
I mainly I wanted to get my knight to f3, so to attack this d4 pawn, I think, which is the weak pawn right now, I feel. And also I can play some moves like h4 g3, but it doesn't, I feel it's too slow. So I played this rook 5 e2, trying to attack this d4 pawn with knight e5, knight
I think
f3.
here you repeated moves and then you went rook
Yeah,
5 to.
I knew. Yeah, I knew this queen c6. I like to repeat such moves here.
You like to repeat. So you repeated this and you went rook 5 e2 so that this is protected and you will get this knight to f3.
Yeah, now I'm threatening this, yeah, where put some pressure on d4 pawn. And later, and also, so he has to protect that d4 pawn with c5, and now b6 pawn becomes weak.
True.
So once again I have to get back my knight to c4.
Ah, smart. So now that d4 is weak, he plays c5, and now you do this entire trip again and you bring your knight back. So
Yeah, now
because
that b6 pawn is literally weak.
what a nice idea. What a nice idea, Arvind. It is like first, knight is not doing much here, so get it to f3. Attack this pawn, force c5, and then you go back and you put your knight back on c4 and attack
Yeah,
b6.
I really like this one. I think I but I'm not a great positional player, but I somehow I understood this position pretty well.
Nice. We have Prag in the chat, and he mentioned this move, rook 5 e2, and also Ramesh has mentioned that you were a very good influence on Prag when he was very young. Is this true? Do you have you been
maybe
helping
this
Prag?
Adding this question should be asked to Prag.
Yeah, I should ask him as to Prag. But I think you both are very good friends and you work on chess regularly.
Yeah, he's like a brother to me, and we three work a lot. Myself, Prag, and Karthikeyan work together, and we are like a family. Yeah,
I forgot to show the viewers this very nice picture which we have here of all the three of them together, three stars of Indian chess, three people who you know, who are going to make India proud in the years to come. All of them from Chennai, all of them working together at Chess Gurukul, and such a nice feeling when I see all of you together. Very nice.
Yeah.
So this game, I really liked your idea. Just to finish it off, how it went was you brought your knight back to c4, attacking this pawn, and then eventually.
Now his queen is queen has to protect that b6 pawn, or one of his major pieces has to protect his b6 pawn, and I think it's not a good sign for him. Yeah.
Yeah, and then you brought your rook.
Yeah, and it was easy. Yeah.
Here you made this positional sacrifice, but actually it's a sort of attack.
Yeah, I'm getting his queen actually by force.
You're getting the it's forced to.
He was forced to.
Yeah, because queen g4 and rook h5 is a threat.
Yeah, so queen g6. I think maybe knight e5 wins the game. I think.
True. So queen h6, check, rook g5, and.
Yeah, mainly for that rook e2 idea. I mean, knight rook e2, knight e5. Yeah. Even rook e4 looks interesting. I don't know why I chose rook e2.
Ah, you mean in this position here?
Yeah, that no. Ah, yeah. Sure, yeah. But okay, I must have had some idea. I don't know.
As you said, yeah, you wanted to defend this pawn.
Yeah, maybe, yeah.
Okay, there's one more game that you like a lot and we want to show the viewers that. Is your game against Tejas Bakre?
Yeah, it was like a study, and I really liked it. Yeah.
Okay, it was like a study. Let's see that game.
You rarely get a study in your own game, no? So.
I know. I have never ever had a study like position. So I'm very curious to know how that game went. I'm searching for that game. Just give me a.
Yeah. Sure.
Second.
And also, I saw one of your analysis that you have given. Okay, let's see the game here.
I have analyzed this game.
Yeah.
Wow.
Maybe in a chessbase article, right? I think.
Okay. Yeah. So you are black.
Yeah, I was white.
You are white. You are white, yeah. And black is Tejas, who is a strong GM from Gujarat. And this is a very well known.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. Is it this bishop endgame?
Yeah, this.
Oh, man, that endgame was very complex.
Yeah, I think white is already doing great here.
Yeah, you have a safer king.
Safer, and yeah, his pawns are fixed on light squares, everything.
Everything is in your favor.
Yeah. So, I misplayed a bit actually. The rook d6 is fine, and this is also fine, I think. Here maybe simply queen to d7 was winning, I think.
You should take.
I don't know which move was this. 36th move, okay. I think I was already under time pressure, and I thought if I is winning by force, but but I did not actually it was winning e5, but I did not find the right solution.
When
e5? But queen d7 was simple, you know, simply queen d7 and king g3 is the game.
Okay,
so I played e5 here.
You played e5.
It took and so here I think I don't remember the analysis, but
I have done it. I find Srinath actually sent the article link in the chat, and I see it in front of me. There's some quite a lot of work I put into this.
I think you missed a critical move actually. That is what
which
I
position?
Yeah. Okay. Let's go on. Okay. Share some other moves are winning. Maybe here. I think I don't know. King g3. Let's say. Yeah. This is the critical moment.
Okay. And white.
Okay. I think I played g5.
Yes.
Fg.
g5. Arvind is alert and sacrifices a pawn to get a passed f pawn. That's what I mentioned.
Yeah.
And I actually gave king e8 as an exclamation move here.
Okay,
okay, you took here, he took here, which is a question mark move in my analysis.
Yeah, both of us were under time pressure, I think.
This was also
this
a mistake.
Yeah, this is the position after h6. Yeah, it's already 41st move and
And now I should ask the viewers to find the move. Okay.
Yeah, one move wins and one move draws. Okay, I said the move, but...
b5 and one move here is useful, is enough to you for to make a draw, and one move gives a win to you. Yeah
What you have given us good move is bad move.
Really?
Yeah.
I should correct my analysis. I have actually given c into b5 should be sufficient for a draw.
I actually
give both the moves as draw.
Okay, but c into b5 is bad actually.
It's bad? Okay.
Yeah.
Let's see. Take.
Bishop b7. King e8.
Yeah.
King e8. I think this is what you analyzed. Bishop d6, king d7. I think here...
King...
Bishop d6.
8. Yeah. 44th move. Bishop into a6. Yes.
King d7. And... here I had this nice bishop c8 move. This is what I think you had missed in your analysis.
I have given only bishop into b5 and king into d6.
Yeah.
And I say this is a draw, yeah?
Yeah, but bishop c8 was the move.
I missed this.
So I was lucky to, you know, find this over the board.
On the board, you had seen it?
Yeah, I had this idea like these 3 points going on. Let's say king. I think king d6 be loses to a6, no?
Yeah, and then just a7.
No,
is coming.
Not dancing c6, maybe king c7 or.
King c7, also a7. Bishop d5, and... f6. Wow.
Yeah.
The king is over stretched. A bishop is overstretched. If he takes here
and a6,
and then you have three pawns.
I think
b4.
B4, let's say.
D7, yeah. No, not only... d7. A7.
I don't remember the analysis, but okay, a7, let's say. Bishop d5, f6.
Yeah, this seems winning, no?
There was this king h5 moves and all, but I don't remember where. I had to bring my king in order to like queen my pawns, or maybe king f5, I don't know. So maybe can you go a little bit back? Maybe king d7, instead of b4.
King
king d7, yeah.
Okay, so take on c8, a6. Instead of b4, come back, king d7, yes?
Yeah, a7. Bishop d5. I think king h5, no? So f6, I think f6 is not good, I think, because of king e6, maybe. Maybe king h5, I think. King h5, king d6, f6, maybe.
Yeah, here King H5.
Oh, no, not king h5, yeah.
It says this position is losing the engine.
Oh, maybe, I don't know, I just
Ah,
need to
maybe
prepare the
F6 first.
analysis.
Here F6 first,
Ah,
please.
okay, F6 first, okay.
Because if you go A7, that's what engine says.
Yeah, yeah, yeah,
Bishop
yeah.
D5, F6. If F6 here, then there is this move King E6, which is
Yeah.
very important.
And king h5, g4, nice. Yeah.
And if King H5,
So yeah, it's about to play f6 first.
okay, I have to update my analysis. Thank you for showing me this. I will change it.
Yeah, sure.
It's very nice that you remember, and you told me on the stream. You did not tell me off the stream.
I actually informed you, but I think you did not see that message.
Really? You had informed me?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry. Okay, today now that you told me, I will make the changes and improve the analysis.
Okay, no, not an issue, you know.
No, but anyway, some future, like someone
Yeah.
will have a look at this analysis and
Yeah, and also, yeah, aim to B5 is the right move. Yeah.
he played it in the game.
Yeah, and he did not play B4.
And here he had to play B4, yeah?
Yeah, B4 was the right move.
But he took here and A6, Bishop D5, A7, F6, and these three pawns are way stronger than the two pawns, and you won the game. Very nice game,
Yeah,
Arvind.
thank you.
And this is actually Arvind's amazing skill, you know, how he's able to win such games with creating something out of nothing many times on the chessboard. And I think I have the honor of playing against you once and drawing against you. We played at National Team Championship in 2013 when you are not very strong. I mean, not as
I
strong
don't remember.
as you are now. In Hyderabad, we had played. And at that time, we drew the game.
Oh.
So it was good. I can always have a equal score with you.
Maybe we can play a game now and decide who is better.
Well, we don't need to decide that. Everyone knows the ratings confirm you are amazing. Jaimin Saheba says, saw you in the press conference. Very rarely is a top player so humble. Wish you all the best.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
Arvind, it was an absolute pleasure having you here, talking to you, seeing two of your best games, also learning about more about your life. About what kind of a person you are, and I wish you really the best in the years to come. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Bhaiya.
Okay,
Thanks a lot.
so see you then, and I will catch up with you shortly, and I hope that we can do more interviews. Yeah, you felt
Yeah,
good,
sure.
Arvind?
Yeah, sure.
Did you feel nervous?
Little bit.
Little, but okay, it's part of
Okay,
the
I'm yeah,
experience.
I'm
You're getting used to it now.
yeah, yeah.
The interviews, and this is great. So great news for people out there. Arvind will be more coming more on the interviews and doing more stuff. So all the best to you and good luck.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Bhaiya. Yeah, see you.
Bye.
Bye. Tata. So, how did it go?
One
Oh,
second,
we
one
are.
second. We are still live.
Oh, okay.
I will call, give you a call in a minute, yeah. Okay, guys, thank you all for being such wonderful guests. Also, a big thanks to all the people who were here. All the strong players, Surya, Ramesh, Prag, Karthikeyan, Srinath, and maybe a few more if I may have missed. Apologies to you, and also to all the wonderful people who were there and you know spamming hearts in the chat, and it was very nice. I hope you enjoyed this interview and you got to know more about Arvind, who is just 20 years old right now. He'll be 21 in 4 days and already rated 2641, three triple national champion, has beaten Michael Adams at the World Cup in an intense match. So, you know, he is really someone to look forward to in Indian chess. So keep a track of him, and I'm sure he'll do wonders in the years to come. I'll be seeing you guys again at 8:30 p.m. in 2 hours from now with the final interview of our series, the 13th interview with Bhakti Kulkarni, the smiling assassin. I call her that because she smiles and she beats players on the board. So until then, see you. Bye-bye.